buzzer is good. Oh, what a play.
Tis 2 nights before Christmas, and there's a message today to win one more game before Big 12 conference play. Today at noon, the 10-1 West Virginia Mountaineers, ranked 10th in the country, host the Fordham Rams from the Atlantic 10 Conference at the WVU Coliseum in Morgantown. Thanks for being with us today alongside WVU Hall of Famer Warren Baker. I'm Rob King. It is the final tune-up for Big 12 conference play. One of the things the Mountaineers, Warren, have been trying to do is find a little more punch off their bench. Teddy Allen, the freshman, a career-high 24 points against Coppin State last time out.
Well, and you know what, Rob? He did it when the Mountaineers really needed it. The offense had been sluggish. Not only did he get 24 points, but he did it with a lot of energy.
Allen doing it from the outside, doing it from the inside. 24 points, 9 rebounds in 23 minutes against Coppin State. Well, West Virginia has won 10 games in a row. They'll look to make it 11 straight with an early Christmas present for their fans. It's the Mountaineers and the Fordham Rams next on AT&T Sportsnet. WVU Coliseum, the starting lineup for your Fordham Rams, who have only 8 scholarship players, which we'll explain, and an international flavor, Tavares, Evans, Chartouni, Rout, and Slanina. The starting lineup for the Fordham Rams, who come in with a record of 5-6. And let's take a look at West Virginia's starting lineup. With Lamont West back in, he was not playing Wednesday night against Coppin State with an ankle. It's Carter, Miles, West, Harrison, Kanate. Bob Huggins coaches his alma mater, looking for career win number 830. That would tie him with Jim Phelan for 7th most all time. You see his record at West Virginia, 239-120. And Jeff Neubauer, who was once an assistant at West Virginia, that was under John Beilein, his record 223-173 in his 3rd year at Fordham and his 13th year overall after having spent 10 years at Eastern Kentucky. Fordham in the red, a very thin team due to injuries. And Slanina and Kanate ready for the opening tip, won by Kanate and the Mountaineers.
And Fordham starting out man-to-man.
They pride themselves in their defense. Lamont West skips to Wesley Harris, wide open three-pointer, no. And the rebound to Tavares.
Good skip pass. Get the defense shifted. Wes Harris had a nice look. Just couldn't knock it down.
Chartouni able to help break the pressure. And now Tavares in trouble. And Tavares will use an early timeout. So let's take a look at the keys to the game here, Warren, beginning with West Virginia.
Well, you want a present of pressure, and we saw that just now. Wrap this up nicely with a bow for Christmas right now, and then the vacation starts tomorrow. Doesn't start right now. You have time to relax after this game today.
How about for the Rams?
Well, you want them to be the Grinch. You know, they want to come in here, be the Grinch, and take the party home. But in order to do that, they need to keep it close early, and they have to do that with good floor spacing. Get the Mountaineers spread out.
Well, we talked about them having only 8 scholarship players. It'll be interesting if they're worn down a little bit. Nemanja Zarkovic out last year with a back injury. Hasn't returned. Doesn't look like he will be able to return. Chuba Owens, 6'8" sophomore. Jesse Bunning, a 6'8" junior, out for the year. So not only guys that are out for the year, 3 scholarship players, but big guys. They are a very small, slight team compared to West Virginia, clearly. Rout trying to inbound, had it batted away by Lamont West.
And we say it so often, you know, it's just no way to prepare in practice for the type of heat that you're going to see when you play West Virginia.
They did get a chance to play Rutgers, who presses, but again, as you mentioned, West Virginia unique with the consistency of their pressure. It is relentless. Chartouni now. Tavares thought about it. 9 in the shot clock. Now turns the corner, takes to the basket, and has it swatted away by Kanate.
Now what's new? Oh, my.
Well, he was eyeing that up from the minute Tavares turned the corner. Fordham staying in the man-to-man defense. Into Kanate. And can't get the roll. Harris, the tip no good. Slanina the rebound. Pressed on ahead. Here's Evans. Trey Evans. Two attempts, two blocks.
And they called goaltending. I think the official said the ball had hit the board before Konate gobbled it up.
Let's take a look. Yep.
Yep. Very good call.
Yeah,
official
it was
in the
a
right
good call.
Position.
You know, it's funny, live I didn't think it had, but excellent call. So an early 2-0 lead for the Fordham Rands out of the Atlantic 10 Conference, and Tavares had it, then lost it. One more look at the goaltending call on the slam cam. Yep.
Yep, it was close. You know, I could see an official missing something like that, you know, but good job by the officials to make the correct call.
I wonder if Konate's got him thinking. Remember that NCAA championship game where John Thompson had Patrick Ewing block the first six shots? I think they were all goaltending calls trying to intimidate North Carolina. Now the miss. Chartuni has it poked away by Harris. Daxter Miles Jr. coming off a game in which he eclipsed the 1,000-point mark, hits the three-pointer, the Mountaineers up one. And Tavares fouled from behind by Harris.
Ball is called on.
Miles gets his feet set nicely, elevates, good follow through, good shot. Yeah, the last time West Virginia in the press, you can see the timing still not there the way it was with Nate Adrian on the press. You know, you have to get that timing down or it can create some good situations for the opponent. It's going to come with time, but it's going to be work.
Tavares, team's leading scorer, hits the first free throw to tie the game up. 63% free throw shooter. Tavares averaging over 16.5 points per game. And, of course, Issa Ahmad expected back, so more bodies for the Mountaineers as well. Grueling style that they play. As Tavares hits them both.
You just wonder, with Fordham, with the thin crop of guys they have here, how long it'll take for the Mountaineers start to wear them down.
Well, Rodney Crawford, an assistant coach who's in charge of Jeff Neubauer's defense and who played for Bob Huggins in Cincinnati, wants to play an aggressive style. But, again, the numbers may be precluding him from putting in everything he wants this year, as Slanina has called for the personal foul. As we saw Konate trying to battle for position.
Interesting. Wes Harris got the ball on the wing, and they backed off, daring him to shoot it. They want to see if he can make a few before they go out and guard. They would rather pinch inside.
Fordham foul call number five.
Now Evans is called for a personal foul.
Second team foul.
And Miles Jr.
Dax comes off of a little screen set by Konate. Seen that a number of times where teams have fallen asleep and he's able to slip in and get the layup.
Well, he also has a knack for annoying whoever he's playing against. And we didn't see that at the beginning, but just after Evans had been called for out, just a little bit of a push-off, a little nudge to create a little room. He really, his physical style, really, we've seen him frustrate opponents over the years. Here's Chartuni out to Slanina. He'll try a three-pointer, and it's good for Prokop Slanina. Prokop Slanina from the Czech Republic.
Slanina hit that. Konate had gone down to help, and that left Slanina up, and he hit it up.
Harris, no good. Kept alive by Rout. Three of their five players, international players. And Tavares is going to be called for a walk here. Slanina and Rout are both from, well, actually, yeah, Slanina from the Czech Republic, Rout from Montenegro, Chartuni from Montreal.
Interesting, you asking about the communication issues that they might have.
Yeah, we were talking about that with Rodney Crawford before the game. I asked Chartuni, he said, no, all you need to know is the word ball. He said everybody speaks English, and Rodney Crawford said everybody does speak English, but it can be a problem sometimes. Two players from Turkish countries. Two from Canada and two from the Czech Republic. Carter going to work and, leaving it for West. Mesmerized the defense and left it for West.
What a play by Von Carter.
That's Paris Hicks, by the way, with Chartuni. Hicks has checked into the game. Well, Chartouni does not look flustered, does he?
No, not at all.
Salina thought about it, batted away, and now Javon Carter beat Chartouni to it, and we're going to have a trip on Chartouni. And this is that Jeff Newberry cannot be happy seeing these early fouls with only eight scholarship players.
Javon Carter left a little skin on the court.
Yeah.
You really don't feel those till you get in the shower after the game. That's when they wake you up.
Well, Chartouni looks like we mentioned Daxter Miles. Chartouni looks like he's got a few tricks up his sleeve as well, having seen him play a couple times. I mean that, of course, for both players, I mean that in a positive light. Here's Miles Jr. and the nice kick from Carter again.
Two assists, back-to-back possessions for JC.
From JC.
Well, Chartouni and Javon Carter are tied with the nation's lead in steals. And here's another steal on West, and Tavares is going to be called for a personal foul. So fouls already beginning to mount here for the Fordham Rams, a thin team. Daxter Miles Jr., a pair of threes. The Mountaineers leading 10-7, 15-53 remaining in the first half.
4 minutes in, the Mountaineers have a three-point lead over Fordham at the WVU Coliseum. I'm Robbie Antzmakowski. Well, with his 11 points scored in the last game against Coppin State, Daxter Miles Jr. received a little pregame recognition and a little bit of memorabilia that he can put on his shelf when his playing career comes to a close. He was honored before the game for becoming WVU's 52nd all-time 1,000-point scorer. And he also received the basketball that he did it with. And get this. Robin Warren, with his last three-pointer that he just hit, Javon Carter passed Fred Schaus for 49th all-time on WVU's scoring list. He now has 1,012 points. A pretty big honor. Bob Huggins added this in his post-game radio show. He said he also might have been the guy to take the most shots to ever get to 1,000 points.
Well, that's a little jab as we see the pass into Bender for the jam. Another assist from Carter and Daxter Miles with 8 points here to lead the way for the Mountaineers, lead all scorers.
West Virginia foul whistle number 2.
That's what Magic Bender needs to do. Take it. Don't worry about it. I spoke with him a little bit before and said, you know, just go up, be aggressive, and put the thing down. He has that ability.
And oh, my, swats it away. So Bender making his presence felt immediately. A jam on one end, the block of Tavares on the other.
How huge will it be if he can play like that as West Virginia goes into the Big 12 action? We know, you know, Konate has the propensity to get into foul trouble. You're going to have somebody come in that you that can take up some of that slack, and Bender right now playing like a kid that could do that.
This is Hofsa, who's checked in the game. Savit Hofsa from Istanbul, Turkey. Hicks looking for help to Chartouni, and Chartouni is going to get the foul called on Bender. Boy, looked like the official wanted to not call that on Bender, but the late reach.
The hand's coming down. If you keep the hand straight up, there can be contact a lot of times, and the officials won't call it. Once those hands drape down at all, they're going to call it. And just like Sags, you have to understand, you can't block every shot.
Chartouni hits the first. Chartouni leads the team in rebounds at 6'3", assists, steals. He's third in scoring. And those two free throws ending a 7-0 West Virginia run. Chartouni, I think, safe to say he is to Fordham what Javon Carter is to West Virginia. Hicks out on Carter. Carter losing the handle a bit, but finds West in the corner for three.
There's another assist. Again, the timing on the press, not quite there. There was a gap, and that's good floor spacing by Fordham.
Here's Rout, three-pointer, no good. Slanina, the offensive rebound.
What mismatch. That's Miles on Slanina right now.
Chartouni, nice reverse layup.
Basket by Chartouni.
They will spread you out, go back door. Good possession that time for Fordham, one that they needed.
remaining in the man-to-man defense. Carter turns the corner, the lob to Bender. Didn't look like he was quite ready for it. Chartouni has it stripped away, but the foul is going to be called on Daxter Miles Jr.
Foul is called on Daxter Miles
good,
Jr.
Good floor spacing by Fordham. Good cut, good baseline cut, and no help side. They had you all spread out all over the place. Really difficult for weak side defense to get back to help.
Chartouni misses the first. He's averaging 3.7 steals per game, tied with Javon Carter. Each came in with 41 steals in their team's 11 games, so that's tied for the most steals per game in the country. And expect it from Javon Carter, but Chartouni, maybe a guy that fans don't know a lot about, a junior for Fordham. Hits one of two. Hicks out, Evans back in for Fordham.
Magic Bender on the bench giving the Mountaineers some good minutes while Kanate took a blow.
Go back to the starting five minus Hofsa being into the game for Fordham. Again, just eight scholarship players, so they're going to have to be judicious with how they're used. And there's Chartouni with one of his steals. Up ahead to Evans. And Evans goes to the far side, uses the rim to protect it, and Fordham within one.
Bob Huggins not happy with Wesley Harris. See Teddy Allen up off the bench. I would anticipate coming in for Harris.
Turnovers the last couple times down. And now a walk. So three straight turnovers on possessions for West Virginia. They've been shooting great. They've hit six of their last seven, but three empty trips without even a shot.
With telegraphed pass. Not happy at all. And then Evans did a very nice job of putting his body between the defender and the ball. No way to block that.
Route being guarded by Allen. Chase Harler's also checked into the game. Evans able to break the pressure and draw a foul on Teddy Allen. Well, you're right. The minute they break that pressure, they are looking to attack.
Yes, they are. You know, Kanate's back there, and they're aware of that, but they're going to go ahead and challenge West Virginia and try to get some. And if not, then try to get good floor spacing, boy.
Oh, pretty inbound plays. Chase Harler had his back to Evans, a lob. Chartouni's a very clever player, isn't he?
Yes, he is. He's always, you know, thinking about what's the next best move I can make.
And he just lost his man in the corner. That's Teddy Allen, but the three, no good. Route soaring for the rebound. I beg your pardon, that's Hofsa tied up with Harler. Goes out of bounds. Will be West Virginia basketball with Beetle Bolden checking in.
Yep, as you had it right, Harler had his back. Did not see that pass. Good set by Fordham. Tried to isolate and did get Harler one-on-one inside.
Teddy Allen right to the basket and scores. You know, we saw last game, Javon Carter throw one off the back of a defender and lay it in. Had his back turned to him, the guy guarding him. Chartouni now tries to go left-handed, and nobody there. Nobody home at all for Fordham. They had two players back. Nobody took to the glass. And that was slapped away by Rout.
These are some things that are bothering Bob Huggins right now, because competition's only going to get tougher, and these type of passes that are being picked off now are going to be gobbled up by Big 12 teams.
Rout. Very close to a five-second call there. Under 10 on the shot clock. Evans right to the basket and can't finish.
Nice move. Everything but the finish.
Here's Beetle Bolden. Three-pointer too strong. Rout and Kanate battling for it. And Kanate gets the ball and then calls timeout. Bob Huggins shaking his head, obviously not pleased with the way things are going early on. His team has turned the ball over consistently here on the offensive end and have just a one-point lead over the Rams.
Well, this afternoon is a homecoming of sorts for Fordham head coach Jeff Neubauer. He was an assistant coach at West Virginia University under John Beilein for three seasons, from 2002 to 2005. After he left the Mountaineers, he went to become the head coach, his first head coaching job at Eastern Kentucky, where he would stay for 10 years. And how about this, Robin Warren? His run as an assistant coach for the Mountaineers culminated in that 2005 NCAA tournament run, where they finished in the Elite Eight, and they finished the regular season ranked 12th in the nation. So you know Jeff Neubauer is having a little bit of fun this afternoon.
Yeah, a lot of ties here. Jeff Neubauer obviously returned here as Eastern Kentucky's coach a couple of years ago, so this is not his first time back here at the Coliseum. But we also, you know, talked about Rodney Crawford. He played under Bob Huggins. He coached under West Virginia assistant Ron Everhart at Duquesne. So, in fact, Rodney Crawford, and you can see him, Rodney Crawford is the guy up and exhorting his team to play better defense as West's shot goes in. So now he sits down, and Neubauer is coaching the offense. But a lot of ties, and Rodney Crawford said he really roots for West Virginia, but won't be today.
Yep.
And Hobson throws the ball behind to cutting Hicks. Fifth turnover for Jeff Neubauer's team. That's Neubauer on the right, and now Neubauer to the left. Rodney Crawford in the background. So Crawford really learning his defense from Bob Huggins. Said not only that, not only other connections, but did he grew up watching Eric Martin and tried to emulate Eric Martin, another West Virginia assistant who played for Bob Huggins at Cincinnati.
Fordham now in a matchup 2-3 zone. They are going to switch some defenses around, try to keep West Virginia off balance.
And here's Bolden, the nice move, can't get it to go, and batted, kept alive. And wow, terrific hustle by D'Angelo Hunter, surrounded by red jerseys, able to bat it out of bounds off a Fordham player.
Well, that was just effort. Peter Bolden, nice job getting to the board, just couldn't get it to drop.
Yeah, really nice job by D'Angelo Hunter. And talking to Rodney Crawford about that zone, said West Virginia will carve it up. And then you have the problem, too, always a difficulty in defensive rebounding out of the zone. And, you know, West Virginia loves to pound the glass on the offensive end as you take a look at Rodney Crawford. So probably not a lot of Eric Martin, as we see Eric Martin over on the West Virginia sideline. So probably not a whole lot of zone that we're going to see. I think just spotted here.
Spotted, change it up. Try it again, especially with West Virginia coming in with guys off the bench, too.
And Lamont West, three-pointer no good. And I think they're going to get Hicks. Yep, they're going to get Hicks for tugging the jersey of Javon Carter.
Fordham foul.
So taking a long bounce.
Foul number five.
Fordham, maybe a couple unlucky bounces here, these last couple shots here for West Virginia.
And when you're as thin as Fordham, you don't want those type of fouls. Now they get D'Angelo Hunter on an illegal screen.
Ball whistled on number 11, D'Angelo Hunter, his first, team's sixth.
Bob Huggins pacing. Hicks able to break the pressure. Ooh, lost the handle a little bit there. Into the corner. Tretunis, three-pointer, no good. And Slonina bats it away. And it's going to be a foul call on Slonina. Now, usually when you see West Virginia game, and if it's being, or Pekarik, I beg your pardon, on the personal foul, when you see it being called closely, that usually works against West Virginia. Today, it might work for them just because.
Numbers.
Yeah, Fordham has so few players. And nearing a three-minute drought here for the Fordham Rams, who have been able to keep it close because of the good defense on the other end. West the pull-up, and Lamont West hits. Ooh, a Chartouni. The crowd here thought he turned that one over.
There's no way they could even see the rim just now with Kanate jumping up.
Hofsa, the errant pass, but Carter can't make him pay on the other end. Hicks hesitation move, can't get around Lamont West, who's forced to cover a much smaller player. Hey, had a couple of nice moves he hasn't been able to finish, including that one. Here's Lamont West. Chartouni the rebound.
Yeah, West almost with a silly foul.
Agreed. Hovsa three-pointer, and it's good.
Three-pointer.
Savit Hovsa.
Right now, you see West Virginia taking a lot of shots. Guys standing around, nobody really crashing the offensive boards. That last shot that West took, no one at all going to the basket to try to get the offensive rebound.
Now doubling Javon Carter. Into Kanate. Ooh. Changed in midair to the finger roll. Pretty move by Kanate.
Nice job, Kanate, too. He pointed to have that ball thrown to Miles because he knew he had good position inside.
Hicks will try the three. Batted by Hovsa, but kept alive by West Virginia.
Fordham back man to man now.
And doing some trapping now. Javon Carter with a little tug of a jersey, and West off the mark. So Fordham trying to give West Virginia a little bit of a dose of their own trapping.
Yeah. Well, that was a really good look. You expect Lamont West to knock that down.
Picard dribbled right into Daxter Miles, up ahead to Bolden, and Bolden able to finish for West Virginia. Lead up to six. Chartouni looking for some help. And now we'll get the foul called on Lamont West. So West picking up the personal foul, sags Kanate. The pretty move, changing his mind in midair, goes to the finger roll. Shade to George Gervin, 6-point lead for the Mountaineers.
It's needed.
You see if Ryan Reeves dropped the gloves as we take a look at
Charlie Huggins.
Yeah.
You know, I was at St. John's Arena one time. He walked in and it parted like the Red Sea.
Is that right?
Yes, it did. Everybody knew exactly who it was. Yeah, Bob will tell you that his dad was the one that made him the coach that he is.
Chartouni hits the front end of a one-on-one. Saw Bob's brother, too, in the Santa outfit.
Yeah. Yeah, Harry looks like Santa there. Probably put a piece of coal in my stocking. I don't know.
Chartouni hits both. Back in for Fordham. 4-point game.
Hugs tells a lot of stories about how hard his dad was on him, too, when he was coming up.
Tough love. It's like years later, everyone remembers the drill sergeant fondly, right, as the guy who helped change their lives. And you know what? Look, Rodney Crawford said he would not be where he is today without Bob
Huggins. Exactly,
and I think
right.
A lot of Bob's former players feel the same way. Tough as nails as a coach. Backdoor to Bolden. Right-handed layup from the lefty. 6-point lead for the Mountaineers. He said, look, tough as nails as the coach. Great guy away from basketball. Up to head to Tavares. And they're going to get him for yet another travel.
Well, really strange to see a game go this long. Javon Carter has yet to scratch. No points. And West Virginia has yet to shoot a free throw. And that sometimes a coach will tell you that's because we're not being aggressive enough.
Mm-hmm.
We're not going to the boards. We're not doing what we're supposed to. Get that ball and power it up inside and get to the line.
Bolden trying to go to work. There's Harris. And Bender able to come up with the offensive rebound. Fresh shot clock.
Boy, Harris really struggling today. And as I say that, you got to jinx him sometime, and he'll turn it around.
He was lining that up, thinking about it, and then finally let it go. And I'm sure Jeff Neubauer would like to see Tavares, his leading scorer, get going. He's scored only 2 points. And now we have the screen from Slanina.
Man, an illegal screen. You have to get stationary and stay there.
Well, that's two on him, and that hurts because they do not have a lot of size.
David Pekarik.
Slanina at 6'10" will give way to Pekarik at 6'7". Yeah.
Virginia Sanks-Kanate.
Fordham has not converted a field goal in over 3 minutes. West Virginia has stretched the lead out to 9. Oh, nice job by Pekarik getting over the top of that screen.
Wes Harris is telegraphing passes, and everybody in the gymnasium could see where he wanted to go with the ball, including the Fordham defense.
Well, and if you're Slanina, you've got to try to, or any of these players, Pekarik, you have to be able to try. Ooh, they're going to put Teddy Allen with the foul, his second personal foul. But you cannot sit behind Kanate in the post. I mean, he's just too big and too strong. Here's a look at that foul by Teddy Allen.
The line for the Rams, number 15, Savit Hafsa.
That's awfully close. A lot of times, though, when you're out in the open like that.
Hafsa hits the first.
And I've been thinking about it, Beetle Bolden in the game along with Teddy Allen. I think I'm going to nickname them the Instant Twins. The guys that come off the bench that can get you some points. Won't always look good, but I'm going to call them the Instant Twins from now on.
Well, we talked about the bench in the open, and Bolden and Allen have both been able to supply a spark. And look, when you get Issa Ahmad back, somebody who's in the starting lineup is going to go to the bench. That should improve your bench as well. We've been talking about Magic Bender. Can he be a guy? Oh, my. Kanate, with intent, was fouled by Hafsa on the way up, but another pretty pass by Javon Carter.
We're fortunate they're not a stoppage in play to put a new rim up. He tried to bring the whole outfit down.
Shooting two.
Look on the slam cam. Well, foul that... it paid off here as Kanate misses the first.
Westby's first free throw with 5:22 left in the half. Both short.
Missed them both, but they do get the ball back. Kicked. Bolden. Three. Good.
Beetle struggled shooting the basketball against Coppin State. It looked really good on this. There's JC with the steal.
And his first basket of the game.
Javon Carter said, "Sags, that's how you do it."
And the lead up to 12 now. Here's Tavares, and oh my, Kanate. Other ideas. Tavares doing a nice job hustling back, though. Fordham's been scrappy.
Follows whistled on Daxter Miles Jr. Picks up his second.
What's the elevation by Javon Carter on this?
On the one end and then on the other end.
You can see Kanate just waiting.
That looked close to the backboard first. Well, Tavares has been persistent. He keeps taking it at Kanate. Fordham, their free throw shooting, keeping him in this game. David Pekarik, part of the under 19, under 18, under 16 national teams. The Czech Republic, one of two.
If all goes well, there's no way in the world that Kanate won't break the shot blocking record here.
Well, he's not only good at it, not only does he have the gift, but he loves doing it.
Yes.
Miles into Allen. Allen, no good. Oh, soaring in was Bolden, and now Kanate able to finish and the foul.
Now, that's what you used to see in the Mountaineers do on the boards.
Give Beetle
Bolden a lot of credit keeping this ball alive.
Chartuni and Rowe back in for the Rams.
It's one of the reasons, again, we said you're so reluctant to go to that zone because you have your back to people. It's hard to box out, and now bodies come flying in aggressively. Beetle Bolden doing a terrific job keeping that alive. Kanate completes the three-point play.
Well, Jeff Neubauer can feel it kind of getting away from him. He's got Slanina, his big guy at 6'10", with two fouls back on the floor. Rolling the dice that he won't pick up that third before the half.
Dexter Miles buying a call.
Yeah.
As they're going to get Hicks on the push-off. Or Evans on the push-off, I beg your pardon.
Dax is walking away with a little grin on his face.
Oh, my. That's... Yep. That's... I think Dax, again, he really gets under the skin of whoever he's playing against.
Jeff Neubauer not happy with the call.
Teddy Allen, three-pointer. And Slonina, they again got a little bit of a bad bounce, a little bit of a bad break, and is Slonina going to pick up his third here? He did.
Jeff Neubauer is trying to get a technical, I think. He is jawing with all the officials. That's the last type of foul that you want a 6'10" guy to get, especially as thin as you are. And no one at the scorer's table right now, so.
No.
Jeff Neubauer.
He's going to change that. Tavares is going to come back in. But it's not for Slonina, it's for Evans.
Yes.
Interesting. And Konate hits them both. Lead up to 16. Fordham, 5.5 minutes without a field goal. Here's Tavares, can't end the drought. Carter the rebound. Dexter Miles Jr. open three off the mark. And they're going to get Konate with an over-the-back call on route. Still a good stretch of play for the Mountaineers defensively and offensively. They've stretched the lead as a team. How about the work of Sagaba Konate, the sophomore?
Just the unbelievable timing that he has. And one thing we've always talked about, he always allows the guy to go up before he leaves the floor, and then we know what kind of force he can be inside.
Using his strength and his muscle.
Everything's been good except the bending of the rim on the dunk that he tried. I think he bent the rim.
7 points, 5 rebounds, 2 blocks for Sagaba Konate. Fordham led 16-15 at the 13:25 mark. Since then, 1-for-6 with 7 turnovers. West Virginia, from the corresponding end, has gotten better from the floor. They started out cold, 9 of their last 19. Taking better care of the basketball after some early turnover issues. On route, shooting 2. It's the first.
Selena is on the bench with those 3 fouls now after the timeout.
Route hits them both. Nearly half their points, 12 out of 26, have come from the free throw line. They're 12 of 14 now, so that has really kept Fordham within at least shouting range of the Mountaineers. Teddy Allen, three-pointer. That would have been a 9th assist for Javon Carter. 8 assists in the game. Fordham a long drought, nearing 6 minutes without a field goal. Chartouni in trouble. And the pull-up and a foul going to be called. The route, excellent three-point shooter. We'll go to the free throw line, 75% free throw shooter. So they have to be conscious of getting out and closing out on route.
There was some miscommunication on the defensive end by West Virginia.
Out hits the first. Hit 7 three-pointers against LIU earlier this year. Hit the first 7, in fact. Wound up 7 of 9. That is a Fordham freshman record. So he's a guy you have to be wary of on the defensive end. Hits both free throws. Cuts the lead back to 12. David Pekarik checking back in.
And the way West Virginia defense is set up, you're going to get some good looks sometimes. If you can break the trap, that's going to create some mismatches and some odd numbers at the other end. If you can get some guys that can knock shots down, that can be a big help. He can certainly shoot the basketball.
By the way, we saw Trey Evans substituted for, and he's gone into the locker room. No further word on what the issue might be. Konate, oh boy, that was a nice job defensively by David Pekarik.
or either he got away with one of the biggest fouls. I mean,
well, certainly the fans here at WVU took door number two there on that explanation. Hofstra trying to go to work, skips in the corner. Chartouni, three-pointer, and he hits it. Joseph Chartouni. So finally, that break, that drought from the floor is broken. It had been over 6 minutes before Fordham. They're going to call that a two, not a three, by the way.
But excellent spacing by Fordham just now. Got the West Virginia spread out. Get the open man for the shot.
7-0 run has cut the lead back to single digits. Canate squaring up. Nice help by Chartouni. Pekarik the rebound.
We saw a number of times the other day that Sachs is getting too flat on that baseline, not leaving himself a good angle.
Chartouni three in and out.
Well, he'd like to have that shot back.
And you're going to get a block call away from the basket on Paris Hicks.
Foul is called on number 23, Paris Hicks, the second.
Second personal foul for him. And they've moved the three back to the two, so the score you see is correct. It is a 10-point lead now because they ruled Chartouni's foot on the line in that last basket he hit prior to missing the three-pointer. And Javon Carter hits his first free throw.
Bender and Harler check in.
Magic Bender, Chase Harler back in for the Mountaineers. Canate and West head to the bench. And Route in for Perry Hicks for Fordham, or Paris Hicks for Fordham, I beg your pardon. So 4 points, two rebounds, eight assists for Javon Carter in the first half. And they're going to get Route for shuffling the feet. This has been a tightly called game, hasn't it?
Yes, it has. I was never a guard. I couldn't dribble well enough to be a guard, but I can't imagine having three guys run at you as you're dribbling up the floor with the quickness West Virginia has.
And Carter turns the corner. And they're going to get Tavares for the foul, and it's going to send Javon Carter back to the line. Tavares' second personal foul. Now, Javon Carter is going to wind up with a chance for a double-double in a unique way. Usually you think of points and rebounds, but closing in on the assist now is 6 points. Hofstra on the move, and Bender back there defensively. Chartouni, three-pointer, and it's good. So Joseph Chartouni having a fine game here for Fordham.
Yeah, Chartouni, the way he's shooting basketball, you may have to pay a little more attention to him as opposed to your help side defense.
Beadle, Bolden three is short. There's Tavares soaring in for the rebound. And another three-pointer knocked down by David Pekarik. So, boy, Fordham, you mentioned this earlier, really getting excellent spacing on
the
floor, aren't they?
Once they cross half court there, and they know where the open men are, good recognition.
Here's Bolden, three-pointer. That is no good. Rebound to Hofstra. Well, we've talked about them being a shorter team and some of their big guys who are hurt, unable to play. They do have a lot of ball handlers out there and a lot of shooters.
Yes.
So once they break that pressure, the spacing's been good and they've been able to knock down some shots. Backdoor cut, skip back out, extra pass, Route the three, and it's good.
Oh, they are in rhythm right now. That's what you call really, really good team basketball.
Lead down to five on a 9-0 Fordham run. Javon Carter right to the basket. So he ends the run. Fordham, though, closing things out with a pretty strong run. A 9-2 run to end the first half to cut this lead, Warren, to seven.
Yes, some excellent shooting and taking care of the basketball.
Let's go over to Robbie Inzmikowski, who's with Bob Huggins.
Yeah, Bob, what keyed their run, and what do you got to do to slow them down?
Guard them. We didn't guard them. They shot wide open shots.
What kind of challenges their defense? Why is it giving your guys a hard time?
Because we haven't made an open shot. Wasn't like we haven't had open shots. We haven't made any.
All right, thank you, Bob.
Yep.
All right, guys.
All right, Robbie, thanks very much. So Bob Huggins, nice greeting with Rodney Crawford before the game, and then some block shots, some good play from West Virginia early, but Fordham using that strong one at the end of the half. 46-39 at the half. Halftime show coming up next. Earlier, three players out for the year with injuries, including much of their size. So a smaller team taking on West Virginia within seven here at the half.
West Virginia back out in aggressive man-to-man. See them close out. West Virginia needs to close out on shooters a lot better than they did that first half.
Here's Slanina, and the shot is short. By the way, we mentioned Trey Evans, who went to the locker room. He is back on the bench, has his hand wrapped, right hand wrapped. Looks like around the wrist or maybe around the thumb. Not sure what that injury is and whether it'll preclude him from getting back in the game. Here's Tavares, the other end. And my, I'm not sure how Javon Carter wasn't whistled for a foul.
I kept waiting for the whistle.
Wow, that was remarkable. But Tavares is able to convert, and it's a five-point game. It's a good sign for Jeff Neubauer. Maybe he can get his leading scorer going. Canate in trouble. Out to Miles Jr. Kicked. Harris, five on the shot clock, able to pull. No good. Canate, the rebound. Jump hook, no good. Batted around, kept alive. And Javon Carter will track it down in the backcourt.
West Virginia's offense just really has not looked in sync. We saw a turnover by Canate with Miles, miscommunication. Javon Carter with a rare turnover.
Tavares and Miles battling for it. Bob Huggins wants an explanation. Not sure.
But a lot of standing around.
Something was a foul there.
Yeah, but a lot of standing around. Javon Carter got trapped just now in West Virginia, basically just kind of standing around waiting for someone else to break to the basketball, and it didn't happen.
Chartouni wants and gets Carter moved away from him. This is Hicks going to work on Miles Jr., kind of expecting that trap, never showed up. Chartouni back door, and oh man, second man through was Harris, and he's able to block it, and now we have a tie-up. And they're going to say Chartouni was on the line, so out of bounds will be West Virginia ball.
Good backdoor cut by Chartouni, and a good recovery by Harris. Very, very smart play by Fordham. You know, if you collapse, they're going to kick it out. If you get too tight, they're going to go backdoor on you.
Yep. Well, we saw Princeton do that for years.
Yes,
right?
We certainly did.
Here's Harris. Ooh, Wesley Harris knocks down the three-pointer. Bob Huggins was pleading for from his team. Knocked down some open shots.
And forced a turnover, a timeout as well.
49-41, the Mountaineers leading 17-51 remaining second half.
Out there and have that happen to them. You've got to be ready to go.
Fordham able to inbound underneath their own basket. Oh, and Chartouni, he broke the pressure and then thought Rout was going one way, and he threw it up. Miles being gobbled up, and Tavares able to close late but couldn't hang on. 17 left in the shot clock.
And I'll say it again, West Virginia is doing a lot of standing. You usually don't see West Virginia's motion offense against a man this stagnant.
Is some of it the pressure?
I think a little bit of it is the pressure, but the timing is off a lot on the times when they want to cut.
Harris thought about it. Ron Carter, Harris, three-pointer, no good. A nice shot by West to get his hands on it, but couldn't control, and Fordham down eight.
Oh, my, Kanate. And Dax Miles will draw the foul call.
Where did he come from?
Foul's whistled on number zero. Will Tavares picks up his third, team foul number one.
The timing is just unbelievable. That guy that size has.
Dax Miles
on the slam, Cam. You can see way up by the top of the square. Sags Kanate making his presence felt. Dexter Miles Jr. at the free throw line. West Virginia five blocks in the game. Miles missing the first. By the way, Javon Carter, we've talked about his fine game, 9 assists. That ties a career high for him, so his next will be a new career high. Hicks in for Chartouni for Fordham. Miles hits a second of two. That allows West Virginia to set up the pressure. All things considered, Fordham's done a decent job,
yes,
I think,
have.
Handling the pressure. You see again, short scholarship players, if they're able to keep this up throughout the game, that relentless West Virginia pressure as a way of wearing teams down. Tavares will get the foul called on Dexter Miles Jr. Third personal on Dexter Miles.
Called on Dax Miles Jr. Third.
Yep, no question. Bump with the chest. They're going to call that.
A couple years ago, you might have been able to get away with that.
Well, the problem with Dax sometimes is that he does get away with those sometimes, and then all the time they call him on him, and he doesn't necessarily like it.
Hicks. Well, you can see nobody from Fordham inside even trying to get the offensive rebound. 9-point game. Harris. And Wesley Harris, the three, that should be the 10th assist for Javon Carter, setting a new career high for him, and the lead back up to 12. Ooh, Chartouni out to route. Yeah, he didn't want anything to do
no
it.
No way, I'm not going in here.
So again, we talk about what the great shot blockers can do. Here's Harris feeling it, missed it. And Kanate with a rebound. And they're going to get on the floor. Foul called, I believe, on Slanina. And no, it's going to be on Route. So not a fourth on Slanina. West Virginia up 53-41.
There's a timeout. Kroger.
At the Coliseum, a block party for Sagabaugh Kanate. Magic Bender had one of the blocks and a jam for the Mountaineers. He and Kanate having their way inside. And the lead at 12 as Fordham has gone on a 3-minute drought offensively. The Mountaineers able to take advantage and push this lead into double figures. Final tune-up for the Mountaineers before Big 12 conference play.
Boy, the big party starts.
Fresh shot clock for the Mountaineers off the inbound.
One thing, if you're a Mountaineer fan that you do have to like, you just never know. You know, Wesley Harris did not start out good. I mean, I think they got a push on Javon Carter.
Sure did.
Javon Carter picks up.
But Harris has come alive here in the second half, and West Virginia needed that production. If not much of a question, even a guy with JC's reputation is going to have that called on him.
Right. Now Fordham, and we saw him going a long drought in the first half. And West Virginia here with a 1-3-1.
1-3-1 now, yeah. Just taking
the able to take advantage of it with a three-pointer. You know, where would Fordham be if they didn't go on these long droughts?
Able to,
you know, claw back in it. We saw both of us watch the game against Rutgers. Very similar type of feel to this game as to that game for Fordham. Harris wants another three-pointer. This one too strong, and Slanina the rebound. Chartouni wanted it a little sooner, but Hofstra had three Mountaineers on his mind.
I think the 1-3-1, West Virginia's going to play that quite a bit. Bob Huggins does that quite a bit in a second half. You very seldom see the 1-3-1 in the first half.
Chartouni, open three-pointer, and it is short over the backboard, and it will be West Virginia basketball. So pretty good look. Chartouni wanted that look. Felt like all throughout that possession and on target, but a little short. By the way, we have not seen Trey Evans back in the game.
No, that wrist.
So three injuries are down to eight. Picard couldn't play the last game because of an ankle. Hofstra missed the game before because of the flu. They have been challenged.
West Virginia offense just not in sync.
Harris driving, and he's going to draw the foul from Slanina, and that will be the fourth on Prokop Slanina.
Ball whistled on 24. Prokop Slanina is fourth. Team foul number three. Wes Harris with the line from out here.
Well, Bob Huggins certainly is going to say we need to clean up a ton of things before we start Big 12 play. This is the last game before they start Big 12 play. It'll be interesting to see how much time he gives these guys off.
Pekarik in for Slanina, who has to go out with a four personal fouls. We saw Harris miss the first. Anything here that's a positive, a chance, because it's a close game, and this is assuming, of course, West Virginia wins the game, but that might be a bit of a wake-up call, perhaps.
I think. Guys, we're not as good as our record shows right now. We've got a lot of stuff to clean up here.
Chartouni will try the three, top of the key, too strong. Carter with a rebound. On the run, and we're going to get the block call. A little bit of a collision there with Hobson.
Fourth foul is called at number 15, Savit Hobza. His second team foul.
The second personal foul on Hobza. Carter a chance to go to the line.
Here's two shots.
2 points away from a double-double for Javon Carter. It's the first.
You know, West Virginia after today will not play again until the 29th on the road. Yeah, two road games, but I'm sure Bob Huggins will give them a day or two off here for the Christmas break, but they're going to have to get back to work, I would assume, by Tuesday or so of next week.
Carter, by the way, his fifth career double-double. First time he's done it with points and assists. The others have been rebounds. Shouldn't say, maybe I wonder if he's had one of 10 steals, too.
Well, no, it'd be interesting.
Hofstra kicks, route, pump fake, steps up, and short. Well, when they get cold from the outside, there's not a lot of offensive rebounding.
No, not at all.
Huge advantage in that department for West Virginia, 13-2 in that department for West Virginia. So they're getting second chances, and Fordham just not getting many. Lamont West, the pump fake. Too strong, and there is one of those offensive rebounds. So big advantage here. I mean, clearly, right? On the one end, you shoot, you miss, that's it. This end, you shoot, you get a 14th offensive rebound.
Lamont West at the line, two shots.
And the second chance points for West Virginia, 15-4. 12-point lead, there's 11 of those 12 points.
Chartouni inside the arc. They're going to call that a block. It looked like he hit pretty good position, but if you are inside of the arc under the basket, they are going to call that a block.
Lamont West hits the first.
Andrew Fender and Beville Bowman check in for the Mountaineers. Checking in for Fordham, Harris Hicks.
Beville Bowman checks in for West Virginia, Paris Hicks for Fordham. And West hits them both. Javon Carter over the top, and Carter
doing a little officiating here. That doesn't look like much, but that's a spot now. The Fordham player before could run the baseline. It's a spot now. He cannot move from that spot. West Virginia would like to force that inbound ball to come into the corner.
We saw Fordham, by the way, living at the free throw line in the first half. They've yet to shoot a free throw here in the second half. Hicks in big trouble, able to get out of there.
Hicks with a hook and got away with it.
4-on-2. 3-pointer on the way, and it's good, so they're able to take advantage as Pekarik hits the three.
There was a major hook down in the corner. Bob Huggins is livid.
Paris Hicks called for the foul, so let's take a look at the action in the corner.
I think it could have been called a foul.
I'm not saying it couldn't have been called a foul. I'm saying Dax is stronger than that, right? He's a strong young man. But listen, he does there. He tried to draw the call there.
After his athletic days are over, you might see him in Hollywood. Lamont West had thoughts of flushing that before he got the ball.
Turnover, and Pekarik in trouble, but there to follow is DeMars.
Just can't get them to go away.
No, they keep coming up off the canvas. They're coming, not just coming up off the canvas, but coming up swinging. Now showing some trap.
West Virginia is just not moving at all, right? I have not seen the offense be this stale in quite some time.
So the Fordham Rams, they've heated up a little bit. It is West Virginia who's gone on a long drought, over 4 minutes without a field goal. The Tavares follow-up has cut it back to single digits.
Oh, Santa Claus went to the Rob King School of Dancing, showing off his moves just moments ago during the break. Well, Bob Huggins picked up yet another honor on Thursday. He was nominated as a candidate for the Naismith Memorial Basketball Hall of Fame 2018 class. The finalists will be announced at the NBA All-Star Game in mid-February, and the final class that will be elected will be announced during the Final Four in San Antonio. Now, Huggins is one of six college coaches that are eligible, so we'll see if he's able to make it. Rolly Massimino, another 800 game winner, one of those. We get a look at Charlie Huggins, Bob's father, and Bob's wife June, daughter Jenna, and the rest of the Huggins family hanging out here at the game. But Warren, you've known Bob for a very long time. What do you think something like this might mean to him to be nominated?
Oh, I'm telling you, well, as humble as Bob is, you know, you'll never see it and know it just by looking, but it has to make him glow inside. It really does.
Just a matter of time.
There it is. That's exactly right.
It's not an if, it's a when. By the way, I was glad to hear Robbie thought I was that good a dancer.
I didn't comment on that. I've never seen you trot, but I can believe that you.
No further comment. Lead is down to 7 for West Virginia. Clever move.
One of the instant twins coming through again.
West Virginia doing some flopping around on the floor, but the officials are clearly not buying it.
That's exactly right.
In hockey, that gets you two the other way, right? For embellishment. Obsa somehow able to slide it past Magic Bender.
Well, you can certainly tell when Kanate is not on the floor.
Yep, a little dissuasive powers he has when people get close.
Fordham in the 2-3 zone again. We saw them do some matchup the first half. Back in it now.
Five on the shot clock. Bolden, 3-pointer. West tries to soar for the rebound. And, oh, nice job by Schwartuni. And here's Hicks the other way. Tied up by Javon Carter.
What a great play by Carter.
Bolden's right hand, no good. And at the last second, a foul
Fordham
call.
Foul number 15,
it's going to be on Hofsa, so maybe a bit of a bailout there. But what a play by Javon Carter.
Be able to stick that hand in and get all ball like that without creating a foul.
Bolden, two shots.
Bolden hits the first. You know, Bolden has There was a time where it looked like he was just going to sort of be a three-point shooter off the bench, but much more athletic than you might think at first blush, and the ability to get to the basket, he's shown a little bit of that as well.
Well, he has good hops, too. He can get up.
Konate has checked back into the ball game. And Bolden hits them both. He has 9 points. Three Mountaineers in double figures. West with 11. Harris and Carter with 10 apiece.
Solis called on Javon Carter, his third. Team foul number three.
And here's the foul called on Javon Carter. Unhappy has picked up two quick personal fouls and now has four personal fouls, and Teddy Allen will substitute for him.
Wow.
And Chartouni gets inside.
Fordham just continually keeps up doing what they've been doing all afternoon, and that's not giving up, not going to fold.
You have to give them credit, don't you? I mean, yeah. they keep coming and keep coming at the Mountaineers here. The lead is 7, and their leader is on the bench. Here's Daxter Miles Jr.
Go to the senior leader. Huge basket for West Virginia.
And too far, Chartouni trying to hit Hicks. And boy, what a big three from Daxter Miles Jr. You could sense things going Fordham's way, and this calms things down a little bit.
It does. And a big read by Teddy Allen. Teddy Allen in the middle of that defense, kicked it out. Miles ready to put it up.
You know, we've seen teams hang around with the Mountaineers over the course of the year, but this has a different feel.
It does.
Some of this is, you know, sometimes we've seen that happen because West Virginia hasn't been playing well. I'm sure Bob Huggins has some things he'd like to see from his team playing better, but Fordham, I think you have to give them a lot of credit in this game.
Well, and you know, West Virginia playing the Atlantic 10 as Miles tries again. Good rebound by Sag Sinate. The Atlantic 10 is just a couple of notches down below the Power 5 conferences. West Virginia hadn't seen this type of competition in the other games.
Lead up to 12. West Virginia scored the last 5 points. Chartouni able to get past Bolden and lay it in.
Well, not good defense by Beetle Bolden, but again, no help side defense at all.
And Bob Huggins wants a timeout at the 8:18 mark. Fordham hanging around, the lead at 10, 67-57, West Virginia.
Thing here, Fordham with that short bench. Bench point, 17 Fordham, 15 West Virginia. You would never think that that would happen.
Fordham in a 2-3 zone. They force another turnover. They've hit their last 5 shots. Here's Tavares, make it their last 6 shots. They cut the lead back down to 8. That has got to drive Bob Huggins crazy. You come out, you set up a play off the timeout, and you turn it over. D'Angelo Hunter has it taken away. And now we'll commit the personal foul, so it will be Fordham basketball when we return. Castillo Hafsa, I beg your pardon, we will be staying here. Tavares with a dunk. The timeout precluding the under 8 official timeout. My apologies.
I don't know if some of the Mountaineers are thinking about what they want to do tomorrow, but I mean, this is going to be an interesting 7:42 left. West Virginia up by 8.
And again, Javon Carter with 4 personal fouls. And that is off the leg of Hafsa and out of bounds. Hafsa thought it was off West Virginia. But it will be West Virginia basketball.
Well, very good call. Teddy Allen with the defensive pressure. Hits the foot and goes out. Turnover to West Virginia.
Fordham back in the 2-3 zone.
West Virginia not hitting the seams of the zone at all. It's passing around the perimeter, trying to get it.
They do you want get to get one into Harris. But it will be, oh, West Virginia basketball. I thought that was not out on West Virginia, but it will be West Virginia basketball. The official's getting tired of both teams telling them what the proper call should be. Miles Jr. to Harris. Three-pointer off the mark. Chartouni rebounds. And Tavares able to follow up. So a rare miss, but Tavares right there.
West Virginia standing around.
Lead is now 6. And Bob Huggins has seen enough. He has got Javon Carter over at the scorer's table ready to check in with those 4 personal fouls. Fordham in the 2-3 zone.
West Virginia just it's been a long time since I've seen a West Virginia offense this stale.
And Miles forced to jack up a long 3 and knocks it down. Wow, as his shot clock expired from 25 feet, and now Tavares has got a chance for a 3-point play.
Goodbye, Tavares.
How does Tavares beat everybody down the court? Only Miles was back.
Next, Miles. That's his 4th. Team foul number
and
6.
Miles now has 4 fouls.
Javon Carter checks back in for the Mountaineers.
So hits the 3 on one end.
One shot.
Personal foul on the other. Chance for a 3-point play for Tavares, who very quietly now with these follow-ups has
Miles,
14 points.
Miles might be lucky if they didn't call it an intentional foul down there. I mean, that was an actual shove.
David McCarrick checks back in for 4.
So Miles and Carter, the most experienced backcourt in Power 5 basketball, each with 4 personal fouls. Will have to lean on that experience to not foul out in this game, with the Mountaineers up just 6.
This zone is giving West Virginia fits.
Carter gets it into Allen, the dump down to Kanate, and Kanate is fouled, can't get it to go. And I think that's going to be it on Slanina. That will be his 5th personal foul.
Prokop Slanina has his 5th. Team foul number 9. Checking into the Rams, number 15, Shavit Hamsa.
Slanina fouls out. They, already thin bench gets thinner.
But they lose a 6'10 guy in Slanina. But really, he has not been a real, real huge factor in this ball game today.
Kanate misses the 1st. And that's going to get Teddy Allen a seat over next to Bob Huggins.
Or as far away from Bob Huggins as you can get.
The Fordham within 6, under 6 minutes remaining. Trying to pull what would be a major upset. Tavares kicks, 3-pointer. Hofsa short. Part of the rebound.
Good job by Fordham getting back.
Carter in the middle of the zone. Goes off the window, no good. Oh, what an athletic play by Daxter Miles.
Goodness.
Miles.
Huge follow-up. West Virginia's offensive rebounding has been a big factor in this game. Hofsa going to work on Harlan. Tavares, 3-pointer, no good. So Fordham has cooled back down. West Virginia now with an 8-point lead under 5 minutes remaining.
Boy, Tavares with a really, really good look.
Tavares' first miss, by the way, in the 2nd half. They've been 6 for 6 from the floor. Whew, that pass almost out of bounds. Little cavalier from Chartouni, but Tavares able to corral. opportunity. Kicks to the corner. Wide open three, and Hofsa can't get it to go.
Tavares had one. Hofsa, they've had two really good looks at threes, set up by penetration, West Virginia collapsing, and then kicking.
There's Chase Harler, hits a big three-pointer. Boy, what a huge three-pointer to expand the lead to 11 for West Virginia. Hofsa kicks. Chartouni. McCarrick thought about it. And Tavares. Oh.
Probably surprised that he was allowed to go.
And Miles Jr. does finish on the other end.
Jeff Neubauer can probably.
So layup missed on one end, converted on the other. The lead now 13 for West Virginia.
Yep, he's got a lot of play. I thought he was going to call a timeout there to try to make sure this thing doesn't get out of hand.
And Rout tries to come up with it, and now wrestling on the floor. Going to be a held ball. It will be possession arrow West Virginia. So Fordham had cut it down to six, now scoreless over their last 3 minutes. And the Mountaineers get the run out for Miles and lead 77-64.
But Dax Miles coming up big when the Mountaineers really need it. The one thing I've seen about Dax today, he's really been ready to shoot when he got the ball. That was a desperation. And look at this athleticism. In among the trees and able to get it up and able then to sneak behind the defense. That's what you need, that senior leadership, especially with Devon Carter saddled with that four fouls. And Dax is playing with four now, but that's what you expect your seniors to do.
Absolutely. You know, the 7-for-9, 4-for-6 from three-point range, the 19 points that leads all scorers, impressive. But just as important, I think the four assists, no turnover. So some of that coming with Javon Carter on the bench with four personal fouls. Miles had to run things and did it flawlessly for the Mountaineers.
Fordham staying in that matchup. Now, one thing that's going to happen, they're going to have to come out of it because West Virginia can bleed the clock.
But Javon Carter instead will shoot a three. No good. Weak side rebound to Tavares. Tavares kind of lost his footing a little bit, and then going to get the foul called. Who's he going to be on?
I think
he'll be on Magic Bender.
Bender over the back.
Magic Bender called for the first goal. His second. Team foul seven.
Bob Huggins not in agreement with that call.
Checks in for the Mountaineers. Tavares at the line for Fordham. One and the bonus.
Well, this has been a closely officiated game for sure. Has been from the very beginning as Tavares hits the front end of a 1-1. Ending a 7-0 Tennessee run, or West Virginia run, I beg your pardon. Tavares, 1-of-2.
West Virginia need not be in a hurry to get a shot up.
Unless you get one like that.
Well, they tried to trick West Virginia to come out and go to a trap real quick. West Virginia read it. Lamont West with the flush.
And that very strong first half now has 13 points. Open three. Nope. It was Pekarik. And now West Virginia seems inevitable. Up 14, under 2 minutes remaining.
Fordham has missed three or four good looks at threes.
Well, it's called a 23. Harris Hicks picks up his fifth personal. Team foul number 10.
Boy.
Javon Carter.
Not any easier than that. Kanate was wide open inside as well.
Kanate, one point away from a double-double. He would join Javon Carter in that department. 11 rebounds, 9 points for Kanate. Four different Mountaineers in double figures. Make it five now, including Javon Carter, who misses the front end. So it's Miles with 19, West with 13, Bolden 11. And Carter and Harris with 10 apiece.
very rare to see Javon Carter miss two free throws in a row.
Carrick out to Chartouni, kicks in the corner. Tavares able to save, and then the double dribble. Good call.
Minute 41 left. West Virginia looks as though they're on the way to the victory, but it certainly was not a thing of beauty today.
Oh, Fordham, they're a scrappy team.
Yeah, they are.
So we can ask Rutgers about that. And there's Konate. He'll get the double-double in style. And one.
I don't think I would stick my arm up to try to stop that. He put arm and all through the basket.
He is physically strong, 6'8", 260. He is the sixth Mountaineer in double figures, first time since the game we had against New Hampshire in November of last year that the Mountaineers have had six players in double figures, two of them with double-doubles, Konate and Carter. Konate, 12 points, 11 rebounds. Carter, 10 points, 11 assists. Carrick, nice pull up. And Jeff Neubauer wants the full timeout here to talk things over with his team. As we head over to Robbie and Smikowski. Robbie.
The date down and come out and watch this Trey Young kid. What a matchup that should be with he and Javon Carter.
Leads the nation in scoring and assists. And there's Miles.
Nice job. Great set out of a timeout. Executed flawlessly.
Exactly. So the lead now 17. Most points Fordham's allowed this year. Hicks, a little out of control, maybe trying to draw the foul. Now Javon Carter and the Mountaineers can start thinking about Christmas coming up.
Yes.
Yeah, you said you were a little worried you were thinking ahead. Miles into Konate. Konate, ooh, missed the jam. West able to follow.
Yeah. West says, I'll take those.
Uh-huh. You see Jeff Neubauer, hands on knees, still coaching hard. Step back three. Off the mark. Ten seconds now. And Tavares drives to the basket. He's able to get it to go. The Mountaineers will dribble things out. Javon Carter. As West Virginia able to win 86-67. And the Mountaineers improved to 11-1, and Bob Huggins has his seventh most victories in NCAA history, tied with Jim Phelan with that victory today. So a milestone for Bob Huggins, the Hall of Fame nominee. I'm sure he's not going to be thinking about the milestone right now, but about what to do to get his team ready for Big 12 conference play.
Well, we can close the chapter on the non-conference part of the schedule.
For a recap of today's game and information,
everything, not that they don't all count, but everything really, really counts now in your trying to get to the Big 12 championship, win it and take it away from Kansas.
Let's head over to Robbie and Smikowski with the Hall of Fame nominee, Bob Huggins.
Bob, how much of a challenge was this game?
Well, I think we took him for granted. He's a heck of a coach, and they really did a good job keeping us off balance with their defense, and they make shots.
What is to be gained from games like this when a team like Fordham wouldn't give up from the start to the finish?
What's the good thing about it? It's over. It's over, and then I get to talk to you.
Well, that's obvious. 830 wins, you tie Jim Phelan for seventh all time. What does it mean to be mentioned with him?
Well, he's one of the legends in our profession, and I worry about winning the next one. You know, I don't have a rearview mirror. I'm trying to win the next game.
The next game's going to come in conference play against Oklahoma State. How prepared is your team headed into conference play at Big 12?
I don't know. Well, I mean, we will be. I think the important thing is we will be.
Merry Christmas, Bob. I'll miss you.
Merry Christmas to you. I hope Santa leaves you some hair gel.
Bob just said he hopes Santa leaves me some hair gel. Come on. What's up with that? Javon, what kind of pride do you take in being the leader of this team as you head into conference play?
I take full responsibility. You know, it's me and Jack Dobb to come out here and get these guys prepared, and we do our best to go out there and fight and pull out wins.
You know, a lot of guys get double-doubles, points and rebounds. You did it, assists and rebounds. What led to your game in terms of giving the ball up to your teammates and leading the baskets tonight?
I think it had a lot to do with how Fordham was playing us. You know, they was leaving guys open, daring us to make shots. It was my job to find those guys, and they did a good job of knocking it in.
If this team is going to be successful as you head into conference play and make a nice run here to the NCAA tournament, what is it going to take?
Everything. We're going to have to come out here and fight and do what we do.
All right, Javon, congratulations and good luck.
Thank you.
All right, Rob Morton.
Robbie and Javon, thanks very much. Double-double for Javon Carter, career high in assists. It's been a pleasure watching him grow throughout his career. And Bake, a pleasure doing these games with you again, my friend.
Oh, yeah. Happy holidays to you and all the Mountaineer fans out there. I really enjoy it, bud.
Same to you. 86-69. The 10th-ranked Mountaineers improved to 11-1 as Bob Huggins picks up career win number 830. For Warren Baker, Robbie and Spikowski, our entire AT&T Sportsnet crew, I'm Rob King reminding you, Penguins hockey is coming right tonight at 6:30 on AT&T Sportsnet. And thanking you for watching West Virginia basketball.